The Supreme Show is an event held annually at the NEC in Birmingham, which showcases the cream of the UK's cat crop. The purpose of this documentary is to find out why people take part in cat shows. Prior to travelling down south, I visited my grandmother, Mary Key, a cat breeder herself, for some information on what to expect.
While it's still light.
So how long have you been doing this now?
Well, I got my first ones in 1967 and then started breeding in 1968. It's now £50 to buy a prefix.
What's a prefix?
Well, like mine's Kaloki.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it's Kalo.
He's the father of Kyber. He's the father of all the kittens.
So what are the judges looking for in a cat?
Nowadays they like a long head, ears like a bat, and oriental eyes. Well, his eyes are good.
A pinch? What's a...
Well, they all have pinches, nearly all of them. Pinches when it goes in, I mean, when they get older, they get them, that where they go in like that. Probably the other ones have got a pinch, probably the kitten. People all say we're mad. I think we must be mad to get up at 2 in the morning.
2 in the morning?
Oh, sometimes got up at 2 in the morning or 1 in the morning and driven for 4 or 5 or 6 hours and then have to stay the whole day at the show. We're all mad to do it, I think. I don't know why. I was on the email with somebody, and they've got stud pants for their male, for their stud.
Stud pants?
Yes. Put them on like nappies, and a Velcro, and they do up. And she sent me an email photo of the cat with it on. And they're not padded, they're just Velcro. And she said, at first, when they're first put on, they stagger about like a drunk, but they get used to it. But I don't think I'd fancy it. You have to buy them in America.
That's just, only in America, Granny. That sounds about right.
So next stop, Birmingham. I guess partly because of my grandmother, I have always been around cats, and so I knew what to expect at the Supreme Show. Even so, I couldn't help feeling a little nervous.
Spend a minute, guys.
It appeared that our permission to enter the arena hadn't filtered down to the grunt at the gate. Following 20 minutes of intense phone calls and haggling, we finally gained permission to enter the premises.
My name's Ken Stoneley.
And what do you do here? I take it you sell...
I manufacture cat scratching posts. So once the cat scratches on there, it leaves a scent on it. So then if there's two cats in a house, then the other one will just follow you, so you smell it and then scratch, and there you go. They're all chasing each other.
So that's what it's about.
They're all covering each other's scent, you see, aren't they? Because this stuff is, it's sisal rope, and it's grown in Africa, and it's turned into rope in Portugal. There's about 4 factories in Portugal that all they do, they make rope.
See, we use a bit of beechwood that washed up. We stay on the shore by the sea, and a bit of beechwood came up, we use that. Got the right idea coming the night before, actually.
I know. It's
couldn't do it otherwise.
Yeah.
It's very stressful otherwise.
Yes.
Stressful as it is.
Well, we come from the Preston area, so we've no chance, you know, the weather's bad, have we?
No.
Not too far, is it?
It's not too far, but the roadworks were terrible.
It's now 5 past midnight, and my granny was supposed to be here an hour and a half ago. And one of the roads was closed, so she said to make a detour. Hopefully everything will work out fine in the morning. So I'm off to bed now.
Thank you.
Before a cat can even enter the main hall, it has to be vetted in. If the vet finds any fleas on a cat, it's game over before the game has even begun.
Calm down, sir.
Mummy's squashing her. She's just pushing her against the bar.
Try and find one of us when your cat's getting taken away to be judged. Yeah?
Oh, I don't know where I'll find you. Look how vast the place is.
We'll probably be in this area.
Somewhere.
Robin.
Hello, girl. That's a good girl.
Casper, come to Mummy. Caspari, are you a good boy?
No. The theme is Death in Venice, the Humphrey Bogart film.
Yes, they're doing a film theme this year, aren't they?
They are. It's a good idea, because if you've got, say, a Rex cat, you can do E.T., Gremlin.
Does it not stress you out, though, all that work?
I think the first time I ever came to a show, somebody was going into the loo and had a glass of water, and I think it was a Valium this lady was taking. She says, I can't look at the results till I've taken this. And I turned to the lady who'd taken me to the show. I said, is this how serious it gets? And she says, yes, only if you let it. But it costs... It's an expensive day, I must admit.
Do you make money out of this at all?
No. the last litter I had 4 years ago, we made a loss of about £200-£300 because we had to have the vet in at 5:30 to deliver the kittens.
Why do they do it exactly?
I don't know. I think the cages are over the top with the curtains and the carpets and things, but that's my opinion. I mean, on Cloughs you don't actually get, you know, to the extent these people go. I saw this cat show about 5 years ago, and they never used to do things like that. And over the years, people are just gradually tarting up the cages and stuff like that. I think they treat the cats probably as children, like people treat dogs as children.
So they're like extensions of the family?
Yeah, I'd say so. Yeah, they're pampered, you can see that. They're well looked after, probably more well looked after than the owners. Yeah, but if that's what people want to do, that's why I see it's part of a family to them.
While circulating around the halls, I heard a rumour about a porno pen. It was time to investigate.
It's up here, isn't it?
Yes. Have you seen a porno pen at all?
No.
On your travels? No?
Not at all.
There's a porno pen about somewhere. Just try to...
If I see it, I'll make sure to give it fairly high marks.
Thank you. Here it is, at last. It's a Russian blue cat in a Russian blue movie. I think that's very clever. Yes, the porno star's a bit shy at the moment. Need to get him a flipper.
Near the toilet, we've got all the way to the
bar. Do you feel this is all worthwhile, all this effort?
To come here, yeah, because it's a bit like the Crofts of the cat world. You can only get them UKs if you come here. He's got his second one now, so that makes him a UK Grand Champion. That's his title now. UK Grand Champion Lyndon Lee Snowcharmer. His pet name, as I say, is Jamie.
Do you make money from this?
No.
I've not met anyone yet who makes money from
this. No, you can't. Oh, there's a difference if you breed.
You don't breed?
No, we don't breed.
But even breeders that I've met still don't breed.
Oh, but they can sell the kittens for a lot of money. You see, we don't breed, so we don't gain anything. But then that breed, they can... It depends on how much they want to sell the kittens for.
I know.
And some of them, I can tell you now, if you... Some kittens, you can pay between £1,500 and £3,000.
Well, it's good street. My daughter's got a better chin in here. I do like the mingling. It's a mingle. You're promiscuous, aren't you?
Mm-hmm. Why are you more inclined with that? Is that Balinese, is it?
She does please me. She does conform. I would like a sort of longer head, but I'm reasonably happy with her. I'm not inclined to withhold her, should I say. The more I look at her, the more pleasing she becomes.
Right, they've started judging. Calico's up next.
Oh.
So,
that's quite new.
Is
I wonder.
There's five. There's five
show
in your class.
Show closes at 5:30.
Yeah.
There's five in the class. I should be bottom.
You.
Okay, right, Calico's coming up now.
Oh dear.
Please return to your cat as it is in distress and requires water. The owner of cat 1371. Please return to your
bed. I'm the hall manager for the Supreme Cat Show, which means I'm responsible for everything in terms of build-up and health and safety in the day-to-day running the show.
How would you change the show? How would you improve it yourself if you had a bigger scene?
That's very difficult because I've been doing this 12 years, and when you've been doing it a few years, you begin to get very sort of staid, and you know, every now and then a new broom sweeps clean and has some wonderful ideas. When I first came in, I changed all the judging rings so that they're in a cartwheel formation. Mm-hmm. And that's the only thing I've done since I've sort of been here. And I've increased the size of the show from half a hall to three halls. The only thing I think we should have is more, like yourselves, but in a bigger realm of the television, that sort of thing. Mm-hmm. But the difficulty with that is it's a one-day show, and you know, you find cables and everything all over the floors. Very difficult.
Have you ever heard of the Supreme Show? Do you know what it's about?
No.
Have you heard of the Supreme Show at all?
What?
The Supreme Show?
Nope.
No.
The Supreme Show?
Mm-hmm.
What's that mean?
I don't know. How are you trying to catch the shit and stuff there? Cats just do what they want, that's what they should do. Chill, didn't they?
But have you got a cat?
Yeah.
And would you ever enter your cat on a cat show?
Nah.
Why not?
I don't know, you won't get through it probably.
I think it's a waste of time.
Yeah.
Supreme Show?
Yeah.
Is that a cat show?
Yes, it is. Do you think it's a worthwhile thing to have?
The cat show?
Yeah.
Yeah, because then at least cats get a bit of a profile, don't they? You get to see what's...
Yeah, but they don't do tricks like dogs do.
Don't need to. Cats just need to be cats, don't they, really?
Cat crafts? Uh-huh. Ah, well, I should tell you at this point, I hate cats.
Oh.
I hate cats. Everything about them, the whole ethos of cats.
So why do you hate cats?
Well, I think that they're the only animal that we treat as a pet and a tame animal, which is actually wild, because it torments creatures for its own pleasure.
So what do you think of cat owners who take their cats to a show as large as the Supreme Show and put them in pens and so on and decorate them?
Well, I don't think I could say it politely. Just, I think they're pretty despicable, really, because to adore a cat that much and to give it so much fuss and, you know, make it into a sort of trophy, I find that a bit nauseating. The thing is, they have a certain allure, don't they? Mm. They're cuddly. They purr, they're nice and warm, they sit on your lap, and it's easy to be fooled. It's a bit like one of those gremlins in that film, isn't it?
Yeah, I think they're bred deliberately like that, so that we adopt them when they're young. And
yes.
Adorable.
Oh, they're very cunning. Mm. I wouldn't put it past them to manipulate their own genes.
Sponsorship. There's been no sponsorship. Was there no sponsorship last year as well?
Yes. Whiskers have always sponsored us up to now.
Is it this the first time?
And this is the first time without sponsorship.
So what does this mean?
Well, it basically means that we had to take a considerable cut in finance and pull in our reins to make sure that we can, or hopefully that we can carry on running the show as it is without sponsorship.
So what have you cut back on? Because I don't see.
Well, they're not so many obvious things. They're things like, say, the judges' lunches. In the past, they would have had a nice slap-up meal at lunchtime. you know, roast, dinner, whatever. This year they've had to do with baguettes and sandwiches, which is a little bit of a cut.
It's 4-3-5.
It's your kitten, isn't it?
Yeah.
How's he doing? Have you been judged yet?
No, it's not
been judged yet. So we've had to wait all this time, and this is it, the moment of truth.
This is it.
Well, at least I'm likely to get this far.
Oh, he has. It gives us a bit more speed than some.
All right.
It's a beautiful.
Anyway, yeah. In this class, yeah. It really could have gone anyway.
Yeah,
but he's a lovely, lovely boy, and the length of the body and the weight of him for the age is fantastic. And also the grooming, that has to go.
What makes
a lot of grooming. I'm very, very hot on grooming.
Are you a judge as well?
No, I've been student today. Yeah.
Are you the emergency judge?
No, I've been studying over there, and I made sure I was finished in time to get over here so I could watch what was going on. Yeah, I've been studying in the long hairs today.
You must be ever so proud.
Very, very proud.
It's absolutely gorgeous.
Very.
I'd like to take this opportunity to thank our judges this afternoon for taking the time coming here and giving us their expertise, as indeed we would like to thank all our judges for bringing us to this point, the climax of the Supreme Cat Show.
So just tell me how Kayleigh got on then.
Well, she was bottom. She didn't do very well. I didn't expect her to. I only brought her to show off her pedigree.
She's a first-rate pedigree.
Pure seal.
Yes.
Nobody else can do that. So that's just the only reason I brought her.
That's no disgrace. After years of selective breeding, numerous local shows, heavy investment, and hours of fluffing, we have arrived at the grand final. Will Jane Haynes win Supreme Kitten? And who will win the Supreme Exhibit title? Just who will be Top Cat?
Which pet's address is the finest in Paris? Which pets possess the longest pedigree? Which pets get to sleep on velvet mats? Naturellement, the aristocats. Which pets are blessed with the fairest forms and faces? Which pets know best all the gentle social graces? Which pets sleep on cream and loving fats? Naturellement, the aristocrats.
And number 810, the red tabby banks. Congratulations.
An aristocratic flair in what they do and what they say. Aristocrats are never found in alleyways or hanging around the garbage cans where common kitties play. Oh no, which pets are known to never show their claws?
Which pets are known? 2003 is number 810. Red Tabby Banks. Owned by Miss Dembski. Congratulations to you.
Best Kitten, Dairymaid Chesterton, owned and bred by Jane Haynes. Champion Lyndon Lee Whoopsie Daisy, owned by Miss Dembski.
They show aristocratic bearing when they're seen upon an airy, an aristocratic flair in what they do and what they say. Aristocrats are never found in alleyways or hanging around the garbage cans where common kitties play.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
So, is this the first time you've won a trophy as such?
It's the first time it's the first big win. I mean, he's won best in show before, but not anything like this, obviously, because this is the big one, isn't it?
So is this like the best moment in your life?
Yes. I would say not bad. It's not bad.
Do you get any prize money for this then?
No. No, it's just the honour and the title.
Surely for honour.
He gets a title and the prestige of winning, you see. There's no money at cat shows. It's all, you're just going for your title. Yeah.
Okay, well, where do you go from here?
Well, he will be neutered, unfortunately, and then he'll start being shown in neuter classes then.
Oh, well, congratulations once again.
Thank you very much.
I hope you don't miss Popeye, though.
No, I'm quite concerned about that, actually. So,
what?
Missing Pop Idol.
Yes. He's getting just a little bit fed up. A little bit fed up at the moment.
And before we knew it, the Supreme Show was over for another year. So what had we learned? Well, it takes a certain type of character to enter a cat show. You need to be dedicated, obsessive, competitive, ruthless. And being slightly eccentric is always a bonus.
So it's wonderful to meet you. And,
thank you. Don't publicise it, please. Else I shall get all sorts of hate mail.
Yeah, we'll be fine.
Okay.
Thank you very much. Bye. Oh, I think I'll be the one that gets into trouble. Anyway.
Baby.